Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to review the components of the Pediatric Assessment Triangle. Now, this is really the first part of our systematic approach to assessing a pediatric patient. And the Pediatric Assessment Triangle is really a gut check. It's a down and dirty, how does this kid look from across the room? Now, there's no numbers, there's no grading, but that does not mean that this is done willy-nilly. It's purposeful, and there's a few things we definitely want to look for when we're looking at this kid from across the room. Now, the components are A, B, C. A stands for appearance, B stands for breathing, and C stands for circulation. Now, A, appearance. What we're really talking about here is their mental status. I know A usually stands for airway, in this case it's appearance, and what it really means is mental status. So that's what we're looking for. Now, we're usually used to treating adult patients, right? And we could use the A&O times 4, we can use our Glasgow Coma Scale, that just doesn't work very well in kids. So there is a nice little tool we have, which is called TICLS. And it's a way of assessing from across the room, when you're looking at this kid, how they're mentating. So, T, muscle tone. If they're picking up this kid and this kid's flopping around and has no tone, stop everything, we're going to work. I stands for interactiveness. Is this kid interacting with his environment? So when you're walking up, is he seeing you? Is he looking at you? How is he interacting with his environment? C, consolability. Is this kid crying and we are unable to console him? Now this can indicate pain in your patient. Next is L, and this stands for looking around. Is the kid looking around? Is he tracking his environment? You know, if a flight team comes walking into a kid's room, the kid should be going, why are these cosmonauts walking into my room? He should pick that up pretty quick and be looking at me. So is this kid tracking? Is he looking around? The last component is S, and this stands for speech. Is the child phonating? Are they speaking? And are they speaking appropriately for their age and their typical baseline? That's what we're looking for. So again, this is the appearance part of the Pediatric Assessment Triangle. Next section of the Pediatric Assessment Triangle is breathing. Specifically, the work of breathing. Is this child having a hard time breathing? So we're looking for head bobbing, we're looking for tugging, we're looking for nasal flaring, and we're listening for audible sounds that we don't need a stethoscope for. Do I hear grunting? Do I hear stridorous sounds? Do I hear wheezing from across the room? That tells us this child is having a heck of a time breathing, they have an increased work of breathing, and we need to address that. Next up, circulation. How do you assess circulation from across the room? We're looking at their skin color. Is there pallor? Is this a pale kid? Is this a hypoxic kid? Is there cyanosis present? Another thing may be looking for redness, periorbital edema, which may indicate an allergic reaction. This could lead to distributive shock, which is definitely a circulatory issue. So we want to look at this kid's color from across the room. So again, the components of the Pediatric Assessment Triangle. One, appearance. How do they appear mentally? B, breathing. Is there work of breathing? Is this child having a hard time breathing? C, circulation, skin color. Do we have signs of hypoperfusion? I'm Mark. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.